Hey.
Hiya.
You're a good kid.
Thanks, Uncle Arthur.
Anyway, I'll leave you to it.
Okay.
Herr Morgan! Herr Morgan!
Mr. Strauss?
You busy, my friend?
Why?
I'll cut you in.
Loaning. Already?
You know how it is. People is happy to borrow off someone like me, but more enthusiastic paying back to someone like you.
Of course. Who are they?
Let me see. A Chick Matthews works at Guthrie Farm. He's a hand, I believe. Mr. Roble, the small holder at Painted Sky, runs the operations there. Badly. Miss Lily Millett is a ranch maid up at Emerald Ranch.
And here was me believing Dutch's bluster about us helping folk.
It's legal work, Mr. Morgan. Debtors belong in prison. We are doing them a favor.
And I'll make sure they see it in them terms.
Put the debts in the deed box and try not to kill them. It's very bad for business.
I just miss him so much.
Of course you do. Goes without saying.
What am I gonna do?
You're gonna suffer. And life's gonna go on. That's the truth of it. I won't lie to you.
Oh, Miss Roberts.
I know.
Where am I gonna go?
Stay here with us. Folk, they ain't so bad. It's nasty out there on your own.
I know.
You'll be safe here. At least for now. Till you're back on your feet properly.
Thank you.
Of course.
You can stay with us as long as you want.
Thank you.
It's the least we can do. All right, well, I should be getting on.
All right, Arthur.
Why don't you sit instead of prowling around the place?
Hi, Uncle. Hey there, mister.
Well, hey there. Look at this, my friend. Tobacco. Nature's gift to us all. Focuses the mind like nothing else.
Whatever you say.
Well, I say, why buy it off the shelves when you can make your own? Well, plenty left here if you're interested. I'd best keep moving.
You're a little too friendly, you know. Knock, knock, Mr. Robe.
No, przepraszam, co pan robi w moim domu?
God damn it. English? Speak English?
Me? Silesia.
Yeah, good
upper
for you.
Silesia.
I'm here for money. You borrow from a German man?
Aha, German. Mein Herr, sprechen das, this, the Kaiserreich,
I don't speak German neither. I'm here for money. Money. That you borrowed from Leopold Strauss.
Leopold Strauss.
Uh-huh. Yeah. So it's time to pay. Where is it?
Well, no, I have nothing. It's very bad winter.
We've all had a bad winter, pal. Where is it?
No. No.
Now, you remember where you're keeping that silver?
Potrzebuję trochę czasu, znajdę ci pieniądze.
No, still don't understand you. God damn it, you have a debt to Herr Strauss. Pay up!
Stop! Już nie mam siły! Nie! Już nie mam siły! Yes.
I have your things. Okay? I have anything in here or out there?
Yes.
What you got behind there?
So, przepraszam, nie rozumiem.
Move aside. Don't even speak English.
Rusakom nie można ufać.
What do we have here?
Moja obrączka, nie!
Just keep quiet. Longer I look, the madder I get.
No.
Yes. Better be something somewhere. You must have come here with something.
tego! I need! I must eat! Proszę!
Okay, that should about cover things.
Easy now. Hey, mister. Buddy?
The blazes do you think you're doing?
Yep. Hi there, mister.
I need to find a ranch maid here called Lily Millet. You know where she is?
She is with Cooper over by the store.
So, yeah.
Take care of yourself.
Mister?
guess.
Well, let's try that again, feller. Hello.
Yep. Hello there.
Miss Millet, the ranch maid. You know where I can find her?
Don't know.
Lily Millet. Where can I find her?
Nuh-uh.
Lily Millet. She's a ranch maid here. You know who she is?
Lily Millet? I ain't gonna get into it on that, mister.
Lily Millet. You know where she is?
Sir, I don't know you from Adam, and I got other things to worry about.
You don't look tough.
You got something to prove here?
It's all good. Calm down.
Waste of my time.
Hey, friend.
Witless asshole. There's no reason for you to be here.
Oh, don't mind me. Maid, Miss Millet, you know where I can find her?
Lily? Just over there by the store with Cooper.
Okay, then.
So long.
Hey, the hell do you want here? Ain't that... Gonna leave your corpse on the ground? Is that it? Shooting it.
Who's talking now, huh?
Mercy on my soul.
Don't make this difficult.
I'm just a ranch hand.
You know what? Just go.
Lordy, Lord, Lord.
Now!
Do I look rich to you? No, stop!
Say it again.
Fine, here. Just take it all.
What is wrong with you? Stop, goddammit! Hey, stop! Hold it right there! You idiot! This ain't a damn choice!
Come on, please!
All right. I hope we understand each other.
I don't believe you.
Hey! back here. You stop right now.
Stop, or you're dead.
No.
Gotta be such a goddamn performance with you. Now, I told you I'd get you the money next week, and I'll get it.
If you didn't make it this week, who's to say you'll make it next?
Don't you take that tone with me. I thought you said you loved me.
I do. I do. But what I get paid ain't enough for one person, let alone two. Your money's gotta be your problem now.
The only problem I got is this bleating going on in my ear. Now lay off it, Lily. God damn it.
Lily, where's our money?
What?
That loan you took. It's payday.
I'm sorry. I don't have it right now.
Well, then, I guess we got a big problem, don't we?
Cooper, give him what you've got.
I ain't giving him nothing except a lesson in damn manners!
Son of a bitch!
Check his pocket. You'll find something on him, I swear. He's got money on him. He has to.
Hey there, mister.
Well, hey there.
Whoa, easy.
Howdy.
Hey there. Yep. Easy now. Thank you.
Chick Matthews?
Oh, no, not me, sir. That's the greenhorn over there. And there he goes.
So long, Long Shark.
Damn it! Hey! Get back here! You owe us money!
Shit. Okay, boy.
Yep.
Hey, mister.
Good Lord, that's a lot of blood.
Hey there, partner.
Why would you go out wearing that?
You can do better than that, mister. Hello.
Okay. Hello again.
Hello, mister.
How do you do?
Each to their own, my friend.
Howdy.
Howdy there. Welcome. Clear this ride up for you. So long.
Legs all numb. Please hurry. Yes. Yes. Just lift as hard as you can. Oh, thank you. Thank you. You saved
me.
Oh, that was bad.
Okay.
I could have been stuck here and starved or eaten. Oh, you poor, dumb animal. Oh, what'll I tell Mildred?
You need a ride home, ma'am?
Oh, yes, mister, please. Thank you. Do you know Valentine? I live there.
No problem.
I don't normally travel this far alone, you know.
Yeah.
I was off inquiring about a possible new line of work. I'd borrowed a friend's horse for the trip. See, my husband... Well, it's just me and my boy now, and it's hard to find work.
I'm sure it is.
A good opportunity. That's what I'm looking for. Not much work for a woman with a boy to raise. I won't work in no saloon, but I've got sharp eyes and quick hands. I was hoping to get a job working as a seamstress. A wealthy man said he'd pay me for the work.
Sounds promising. Also doesn't sound real.
Oh, you may be right, I suppose. He said he'd provide room and board for me and for my child. What are you doing?
I'd be careful with offers like that, ma'am.
I can't afford to dismiss offers like these, even if they do seem... odd.
Just be careful is all I'm saying.
Yeah.
I may not have another opportunity like this. Now I'll have to pay Mildred back for her horse.
It sure sounds like you're in a hard position.
You finding me is the only good thing that's happened to me in a long while.
Mister?
Oh, God!
Mister.
Hello over there.
Come on.
Can you please stop?
We're here. Thank you for all your help. You're a good man.
Glad I was able to help. You take care. Appreciate it. You be well.
Howdy, partner. Come on, get clear.
You know what I hate more than being drunk? Is other drunks.
What am I doing?
Funny how a hand can play out.
You ain't worth two shits, whole damn lot of you.
You're worth one tree. One
Hello.
Buffalo. One Redskin. I shot 19 of them once. Well, buffalo, not redskins. Don't know how many redskins are killed, but they deserved it. They weren't Christians, so I sent them to hell. They should have thanked me. All you fools should thank me.
Hey there.
What do you want?
Hello there, sir. Don't think I've seen you around here before. All right. What can I do for you?
Ain't no Wild West no more around here. Ain't nothing.
Nothing nice. It's more... goddamn America. More goddamn shops. More goddamn prissy women in men's clothing and women in women's clothing thinking they must be men. My old Bessie, she could skin a bear with her teeth, so help me God. Look at you. Y'all make a fella sick.
What's wrong with you fools? Well, look at y'all. Look at you. My time? Men was goddamn men. You ain't men, the whole lot of you. Look at you. You ain't men. You ain't even women. You're something else.
Is this some dry blood?
You're revolting.
No questions.
I'm revolted. I'm tempted to gouge my eyes out just for the fact that they saw you. I wouldn't do you the dignity of pissing on you.
Thanks, Mister.
None of you. Oh, God. I can't believe what this dump is coming to.
Evening.
Law's here.
Hello, gentlemen.
You ain't even half a man. I'm not right.
Well, hello there.
Yep.
Will you?
Hey.
You got a problem?
Evening. Come on! Out of the way!
Get your news here, Valentine.
Hey there!
Good evening.
Go easy on that stuff, Bill.
Mr. Arthur, I told Dutch I feel I should tell you. I saw some of Combs' boys riding around.
Down here? What they want?
I have no idea.
They see you?
I don't think so.
Okay. Well, thanks for letting me know, Kieran.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, let's talk more later.
Yep, all right, man, I'll see ya.
That was quite a feast.
Thank you.
My pleasure. My pleasure.
So tell me, do you ever miss the sea?
Always. Every day. Why don't you go...
How did you get on, Herr Morgan?
Fine. Our accounts are up to date. Sad sacks, a lot of them.
Good, very good.
My pleasure.
Well, if it's pleasure you're after, there is one other. This farmer preacher fellow I met in Valentine, Mr. Downs.
The opinionated little do-gooder? Yeah, I know the one. I certainly know the type.
Thank you, Herr Morgan.
There's no need to thank me. Like you said, it's a pleasure I'm after.
He's more slippery than he seems. I've tried being polite. Don't take any nonsense.
Nonsense? Me?
If he doesn't have the money, beat him.
Well, I usually do.
I know. I know.
Arthur.
Dear Arthur, I've written this letter 100 times or more, and I cannot get it right. It's me. You know it's me from the bad handwriting. I know I said when we last spoke, and I was going off to get married, that we would not speak again. I know I said a lot of things, and I meant them, I suppose, at the time. But I'm not so proud as to not speak to people who care for me, or cared for me. I've been in Valentine for a couple of months. I had some bad luck, and, well, it's a long story and not an interesting one. But I am here for now. I saw a couple of the girls, or whatever the polite term is for them, that ran with you and your associates in town. And I heard tell of a man who sounded like you. I would love to see you again. If you could spare me a little bit of your time. I'm renting a room at Chadwick Farm, just north of Valentine. Yours, Mary Linton.
Okay.
Good morning.
Hey, Arthur.
Hey, get up.
What do you want?
You were snoring, that's all.
Just go to bed, Arthur.
Okay, Abigail.
Settling in.
Good.
Morning, Arthur.
You got everything you need, Miss Grimshaw?
Oh, not by a long shot, Mr. Morgan. We lost a lot in the move.
We'll be back on our feet soon.
Sir?
Not you again. The preacher, I remember.
Soon, please.
Yeah, yeah.